Brooks Belanger here with BMB Drainage Solutions, and on this beautiful day in January, out here doing my mid-afternoon walk around the lake, but it's not what this video is about. If you followed my channel for some time now, back in mid-July of last year, I posted this video up. You may remember it. So something that should have been a pretty much straightforward, easy project turned out to be anything but. When we started on the top portion of the lawn. This is the section where we were installing 80 feet of NDS Ezflow. And we get in there and we came across something that's quite common in the Northwest Arkansas area. Have a look. More importantly, listen. So what you're hearing there is a rock formation, which is quite frequent throughout the Northwest Arkansas area. That's chert. It's a very hard rock. It's very difficult to dig out, even with a mini axe. Typically what you have to do is continuously pound it with the bucket until it fractures, and then you can dig it out. So that put us behind right there, where we should have been so far as time. When we finished that up, started pulling it back, backfilling it. So once we got that area backfilled and got it completed, we moved down to the lower portion of the lawn, hoping that things would go a little bit smoother, and praying that we wouldn't continue to run into the chert, the rock formation. Get down there, and it turned out to be something that we never expected and could have never foreseen. So take a look. So that stump wasn't a stump. It turned out to be a full-blown tree with the top cut out of it. So whenever we discovered that, we knew that we were into something that was way beyond the ordinary. So we spin the mini X around, and if you remember from the original video that I posted, there were some cracks along that area that was sinking. We dug around there, pulled the sod back, scraped the dirt back. Not much, it didn't take much. And this is what we found. So what we discovered is that this lawn was basically a graveyard for trees and tree debris, and we knew that we didn't have the right equipment on site, so we had to bring in a larger mini X. So we get it on there and we go to work, and I'm here to tell you, we were at depths of anywhere from 12 to 15 feet deep, and we were pulling trees, and we kept pulling trees, and we pulled even more trees.
No way, dude. There you go.
Look at this.
You got it. Now that- Damn.
This job so difficult is that, and you'll see in these next couple of clips, is the trees were so large, even whenever you would get a hold of one and you would try to pull it out, you couldn't break it. Lots of times, some of them you could, some of them you couldn't. So you would have to expose, if not all of the tree, a greater portion of it, which required you to expose it, coming back, get it out, drop it off to the side, and then you'd have to push all the dirt back so that you could then again go forward to grab more trees to get them out. So it was a long, tedious, pain in the butt process. You know, not only did we come across tree debris, we also came across boulders. These were, you could tell these boulders weren't put there by nature. They were purposely thrown in there to perhaps compact and hold down all the tree debris that were thrown into this area. And then, the craziest thing was that we pulled up on this job, if everything else wasn't crazy enough, we pulled up a copperhead.
Copperhead or a water moccasin.
And he wasn't dead, he's still alive, he was twitching and all that good stuff.
Man, watch out behind you.
At that point, when we pulled that snake up, we were at depths, I believe, of 10 to 12 feet. We were still pulling up tree debris, and that snake had to be down in there. And, you know, not on purpose, didn't see it. It came up with the bucket, and unfortunately, due to the way that he got caught, he didn't fare so well.
Hey, Dad. That'll be good.
It goes without saying that no one, ourselves or the client, knew what we were getting into beforehand, before this job was started. It's unfortunate that especially for the client, it's unfortunate for him that the developer or the builder chose to put all that, bulldoze it in there, and then backfill it with red dirt and topsoil. Just for time reasons, for this video, I'm going to put in the description below a complete detail of what all was found out once we got into this particular part of the job. So if you want more details, be sure to read them in the description. This job was definitely something that I have never experienced in my life. I'll probably never experience another job like this in my life. Just the craziest thing I've ever seen. You know, we finally did get it completed. I do have some footage of the property all said and done, but I'll have to dig it up and hopefully post it within the next 7 to 10 days. You know, not to end on a negative note, I'm going to put some clips up of the job as we went through the project and continue to work on it. Some of the things that actually went right for us, because there were some, not everything went wrong. So I'll put those up at the end. In the meantime, if you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends. Any questions, any comments, always put them down below. Love to hear your thoughts. And don't forget to subscribe. As always, thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you then.